So here's some prerequisite tools you'll need. You'll need some tweezers, a small round file, a razor blade, some wire cutters, and some wire strippers. You'll also need the connection for a triaxial cable, the end bit. And it helps to have this table clamp. You don't need it, but it really, really helps. Makes it a lot easier. And if you're soldering, helps to have a little portable hood. So, yeah, that's stuff you'll need. Okay, so if you have a clean cut to the end of the cable, then you can begin. Otherwise, make sure that you have a really clean end of the cable cut. So there's that. Begin by cutting about an inch or so down. And kind of stripping the wire across. And then cut down the length of the body.
Once the end is off, we can start adding pieces. First, the base, then the small metal ring. And then the rubber tube. Now we screw on the metal piece over the shielding from the cable, ensuring that the shield goes through the metal piece as one unit. Once the metal piece is on, we can fray the shielding over the metal piece uniformly to ensure maximum conductivity. The metal cover clamps the shield to the previous piece. Once it is on, we can trim the excess shielding using the wire cutter. Next, on goes the white plastic piece. We then use a razor blade to remove the insulation for the metal conductor. After the insulation is gone, it is time to put on the base for the metal conductor. We found that some filing makes the job a little easier. Once again, the metal piece goes over the shielding. Here's another look. Once securely on, we can free the shielding. This metal ring forms a secure connection between the shielding and the metal piece. Once again, we can use a wire cutter to clip the edges of the shielding. The next step is to remove the insulation for the center pin. Once the insulation is removed and the wire is exposed, we can solder the pin to the wire. Next, we place this white covering over the pin. And this gold covering makes a secure fit for the center conductor. In the final step, a white covering and the outside shield complete the cable.